I have the Google Pixel 8 here, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how we can uninstall the Gmail application. Now, I wanted to do a video like this because I understand that not everyone is a fan of the pre-installed apps that Google puts on our Pixel devices. So this video will work if you have a more recent device, like the Pixel 8 series, Pixel 7 series, or the Pixel 6 series. But it will also work if you have an older one as well. This will work even if you have an OG Google Pixel that you're currently using to upload all of your photos. Now, before I show you how to actually uninstall it, most people may be okay with simply disabling the Gmail application instead. And since that process only takes a few seconds to complete, it's more than worth it for some people. This is done by bringing up the app info page for the Gmail application. And we can do this by performing a long press gesture on the Gmail application icon so that we can then tap on the app info option in that pop-up or the little eye icon that appears there. We can also get to this page by opening up the settings application, finding the apps menu, and then locating the Gmail application from that list. Both methods will bring you to this page, and it's from this app info page that we can usually disable the application with the disable button right here. So we tap on that disable button, confirm that we do want to disable it, and now that disable button will change to enable since we have actually disabled it. There are times when that disable button will be grayed out, but it's almost always worth checking before going through the process of uninstalling it with an ADB command. So definitely try just disabling the Gmail application and seeing if that is enough to get it out of your view. If it isn't, then we can transition to uninstalling the Gmail app with ADB on all Google Pixel smartphones and tablets. Now, if you haven't done so already, make sure that you have ADB and Fast Boot tools installed on your PC. If you don't have these tools installed yet, then be sure to check the video description below, and I'll include a link to a dedicated video that I have previously done that will walk you through installing ADB and Fastboot++. Then, with that done, you will also need to make sure that USB debugging mode is enabled. And again, if you don't know how to enable developer mode so that you can toggle USB debugging mode, then I'll have those links in the video description as well. Then, we're going to connect our Google Pixel to the PC with a USB cable, and then open up a command prompt, Windows PowerShell, or a terminal window from within the same folder as our ADB and Fastboot tools. Personally, I like to make sure that I have a proper connection from the PC. So I like to execute the command ADB space devices from within that same folder as our ADB and Fastboot tools. See, if we get a blank list of devices, that means there has been an issue. Either you haven't enabled USB debugging mode at all, or you haven't granted this PC proper access. It's not until you execute the ADB devices command and you get the serial number of the device that is connected, then you will have a proper connection from the PC to our Google Pixel. So now we're going to drop into an ADB shell, which should bring you to a different prompt that looks different than what we were at before. This will have the code name of our Google Pixel device that's connected. And then we're going to type out the command pm space uninstall space -k space dash dash user space 0 space com.google.android.gm. And I'll have this entire command in the video description below so that you can just copy and paste it if you'd like. This tells the package manager, PM, within Android to uninstall the application with the package name com.google.android.gm, which is the Gmail app. And we're going to uninstall this from user 0, which is us. And we're telling it to keep our user data with the dash K parameter. That way, if we ever want to reinstall it in the future, then we still have all our data in place. Then we can just press enter on the keyboard. And if everything went smoothly, then you should see a success message here. Not only that, the Gmail application should completely disappear from our device. We shouldn't see it in the app drawer or the home screen at all. So if you remember, I had that Gmail app icon on a blank page of the home screen, and that's no longer there. It's no longer where it was before. And even if I bring up the app drawer, the Gmail application is nowhere to be found. I will be sure to include the details on how to reinstall this app in the video description below if you ever decide to change your mind and want the Gmail app back on your device. This application will stay off of your Google Pixel smartphone or tablet, even through over-the-air updates, unless there is a specific update that actually changes the Gmail application. And since that is actually quite rare, you're unlikely to see it reappear on your device unless you execute that install existing command that I just mentioned, or you factory reset the device. Now, if you have any problems along the way, or if you just have a question about this process, then please do not hesitate to leave a comment down below, and I'll be sure to reply as quickly as I'm able to.